about you? Prepare to meet my body when the comet comes through. Walking on you, the comet comes through. Why you always hate to break bread? Think about the way that you will feel a deficit. Jokes on you, when it's time to come through. Okay, what's up, folks? How you doing? Welcome back to the channel. I hope you enjoyed that little montage. Today I'm gonna be showing you what it takes to make a production like that happen. Like how the hell I was able to get a plane, a motorcycle, an airport, everything on board to kind of like finesse that situation. This was one of the best shoots that I've had in years. I had so much fun with shooting for it, and I just wanted to show you kind of like what it takes to make a production like that happen. First things first, I want you to know that a lot of these things that you see on the internet, it's just by luck. Don't be afraid to like reach out to people on Instagram. If you see something cool and you're like, hey, that looks sick, I want to do that, then just swipe up, message the person and be like, yo, what's good? I like what you did. Can I come through and do it too? I find that that's like the most effective way. To be honest, a lot of times I've had a lot of people say no, but there's no water in my glass. I've had a lot of people say no, but if you ask a lot of people and you're trying to get into a bunch of different situations, you're gonna have one person say yes, and that's gonna in turn lead to like a whole bunch of cool opportunities. So I messaged this girl after finding her image on the explore page, and I was like, this is an awesome photo. I'd love to be able to come through. I don't know where you live, but I'd love to come and hang out with you and shoot this kind of photo. And she was like, yeah, sure. So I was like, okay, say no more. I'll come through in like maybe like a week or 10 days or something, and we can set something up. So after the whole process of like setting it up, I was like, okay, this is fun. I really enjoyed the photo that she created, but I wanna find a way that I can do it differently. How can I make this photo different? I like things to look like magical and ethereal, but I also like a lot of motion in the shot. So maybe if I could get like a motorcycle rider underneath the plane as the plane's flying by, instead of just like a girl standing, I feel like it could be like a very cool experience. So I immediately put it on my story. I was like, whoever lives in Kentucky or lives near Kentucky, please, if you know anyone who had a motorcycle, I would love to like create some stuff with them. But within like a day, I was able to find a motorcycle rider who lived in the area who was down to come through and shoot. So that was the beginning of how I finessed the situation. Obviously, you know my workflow. I created a whole Pinterest board of like motorcycles and planes and just saved a whole bunch of things for kind of like inspiration, just to get my juices flowing and to get everything locked in. So I drove to Kentucky and I pulled up to this farm. It was like a farm area, and the guy who owns the planes actually owns like a tiny little bit of airstrip, because the airplanes that he flies doesn't need like a lot of runway to take off. So he owns like a little bit of airstrip that we would actually use for the shoot. It was just like a tiny little grass strip, but having your own airstrip allowed us to be underneath the plane or to ride the motorcycle like along the airstrip and make these cool images that I wanted. So the whole idea for the whole photograph was motion. I wanted there to be like a whole bunch of motion in the photograph. I wanted that whole like zoomy, speedy effect that you see in some of your photographs, so that when you look at the photograph, the first thing that comes to my mind is speed, or like, man, there's so much energy in this. And in order to make that happen, what I did was I sat on the back of a little golf cart, like a really fast golf cart, as the motorcycle rider would ride to me as fast as he could, and the plane would fly above our heads. So in the images, it looks like the plane is just taking off over the head of the motorcycle rider. But in fact, what we did was we'd have him take off, and he'd fly and come and buzz right over the runway and take off again and buzz right over the runway and take off. And what we do is we'd just be riding underneath, spraying to God and hoping that I was able to get like a still photograph. Now, because I wanted to get a whole bunch of motion, I had to like turn down the shutter speed of the shot, which meant that a lot of the images that came out of the experience were very blurry. But if you shoot a lot, and if you shoot like many photos, one of them is gonna turn out crisp, and while the background is blurry. So I just shot and shot and shot and shot again. And I was very, very, very impressed with what we got from the whole experience. This whole thing was a very big learning experience for me. I figured out that I shouldn't be afraid to like reach out to people and to like step out of my comfort zone, especially people who have something very cool going on and say, hey, I would love to be a part of whatever you got going on, because if you don't ask, you won't be able to be told yes or no. So might as well reach out and see what happens in this situation. So definitely very happy that I was able to reach out and Rachel was interested in creating some stuff with me. So I'd be a lot more open to stepping out of my comfort zone and just like messaging people and saying, hey, what you got going on, man? I'd love to be a part of that. Because that's basically the only way that you can make things happen in 2020. Just step out of your comfort zone and just ask people. I'm very, very, very happy with the turnout of the photos. It's really beautiful images, all full of energy. Even before we started shooting the planes, I'm just really happy with the whole outlook of the whole thing. I'm very impressed. Shout out to everyone who was involved with the production as well. You know, the Bush sisters, those girls are so awesome. Rachel, who like set the whole thing up. And then shout out to Tony, who's the motorcycle rider who drove all the way from Nashville with his motorcycle in the back of a U-Haul truck. That was also pretty sick. I'm so glad that we were able to finesse that situation. And then shout out to Cal as well, who owns the plane, who made the whole shot as fantastic as it was. Please feel free to go check out these guys on Instagram. I'm interested to hear what you think about the images. Did you enjoy them? Did you like them? Yeah, that's it. Thank you guys for watching. I know this is a bit of a short one, but I just wanted to share this whole experience with you. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.
That was really good.
My camera got fudge all over it. Manager Joe, you look like the band manager right now. Where the fuck is Alvin? Stage 3.
What? It does slow-mo? Rachel, this is cool.
I don't know.
Sorry, what? What are you saying?
Driving starts to go like this way.
But I get one hair out.
Yeah. You do look like a driver, like literally.
You look like you're in a sports car with an old man.
I come for it?
Yeah, sorry.
At this time, I'm going to ask that you fasten your seat.